Welcome to Real Magic Review. My name is Steve Faulkner, and this is The Dark Side of the Cube Revelations by Diego Voltini. Before we do this, can you please like, subscribe, have a look at cardmagiccourse.com. I don't know if I've mentioned this before, but that's my online card magic course. I mention it every time, I know. But I will always mention it because it's important. Cardmagiccourse.com, loads of videos, weekly sessions, live sessions on Zoom. They will always go on. It's not just a lockdown thing. From beginners right to professional level stuff, if you want to learn your second deals, bottom deals, you can learn that. And if you go, actually, I didn't quite understand that, you can get in touch with me and I will clarify that either with a video on the course or with a private video. This is not something that's a passive income thing. This is something I'm sort of dedicating everything to. So do check out cardmagiccourse.com and do all the good stuff. And share this if you want, if you like it, have a little share of it. That'd be good, wouldn't it? Because then more people will watch it. Dark Side of the Cube, I reviewed this a while ago. I'm not going to go into it, but the very briefly, it's a way you, with a Rubik's Cube that you, it's a colour predict, not prediction, but someone, you say someone think of a colour or write a colour down on a bit of paper or many, many methods, and they don't know that you know that colour. So, and there are various ways of doing that, and you do something to the Rubik's Cube, which looks like you're just either playing with it or you put it in a bag quickly, pull it out, and then you've got a colour match of the colour they're thinking of. So it's kind of mentalism routine. It's a reveal of a mentalism routine using a variety of methods, but the reveal is one side of the cube is shown to be the colour that they have, all right? So it's based on that. And when I first read it, I kind of went, well, it's all right. But then the more I read it, the more I thought, actually, it's quite powerful, because the whole point of this, he takes that concept and then gives you all these routines around it. So it's a completely ungimmicked cube, and it's based on one algorithm, basically an algorithm. You get the cube into a state and go, right. I mean, they could just say, you say name a colour. Yeah, you get the idea. So, another book on that, and you go, blimey, and the book's bigger, you know. So basically, what this is, and I do like this because you can take this learning into other routines as well. This is the really the competence bit. This is the learn how to do it. Learn how to get the cube into a state quickly after they've decided upon their colour. And I'm not really selling that very well. It is pretty strong, this. This is what you can then take and do with that. This is just sort of geeking out on that idea. And the reason I like it isn't because, oh, I've got 28 ways of doing that. And it isn't 28, I don't know what it is, but loads of ways of doing that. It's actually, it makes you think you've got a simple concept, not that easy to do, but simple idea, and you can then take it forward and give it all of these different meanings and use different props of it and present it in so many different ways. And it makes you go, God, it's such a simple idea. But you've then got these levels of magic on top of it, which can make it more and more impossible or meaningful, all from a Rubik's Cube. There's lots of really nice stuff. There's a kind of memory box routine where it totally justifies the use of the Rubik's Cube. And it also incorporates an iCube, Hugo Shelley iCube, in a really hidden, nice way, which again is going to add so much deception to the routine. There's a lovely routine called Candy Cube, where you use Skittles. It's kind of, there's an old force that we're using coins in mentalism that you use sweet Skittles to do, which I thought was really nice. And again, really interactive, and that is going to get you to that that colour. There's a routine. There was a routine using an IKEA box in the first book, and there's another one using another prop, using IKEA in a different way, and kind of getting a really nice kind of presentation around, you know, the idea of IKEA stuff being really hard to put together. There's also a section on different ways to do the algorithm, and it's basically, in the first book there was a thing you had to do to the cube to get it in the correct situation, which actually felt a bit like, can't really, do I have to do that? But actually it takes seconds. And I realised that was all before performance anyway. This gives you alternative ways of getting into that. And it also gives you loads of stuff, like if you want to do this with someone else's cube that isn't like a really good speed cube that you might have? Yeah, how is there different algorithms to do when the cube is kind of sticky or when it's a miniature cube? There's loads of stuff with miniature cubes in this, which again you might think, well, you've got a miniature cube, but there are different things you can do with that. And actually I've seen a few routines pop up recently using miniature cube. One of the things I saw Eric Jones do on a public performance on TV was this thing of solving a cube in his mouth with a miniature cube. So there's something quite cool about them, and he incorporates them in various ways as well. I've spent quite a lot of time with this, and I don't know why. I don't mean that badly. Oh yeah, it's got this fortune folding force. He's got stuff that comes away from the cube, different ways of forcing the colour that feel very fair, using a kind of origami type thing, which is great. And the only thing I'd say is I really enjoy. When I say I don't know why I enjoyed it, it wasn't just because, like I said, it was just I enjoyed reading it, I enjoyed learning it, I enjoyed playing with it, I enjoyed looking at the different things, and there were a few ideas that came to my head springboarding off these ideas. So I wouldn't see it just as a, yes, I want more on that method. See it as a little bit more than that. But it is, you know, it is something that you're going to really have to be into. It's, you know, if you're into this, you're going to be into this. And incidentally, this is a companion piece to that. There's no point in getting the second book without the first book. So it's kind of an extension on that. And it's nice to see someone go really, really, really deep with this stuff. But it's certainly not for everybody. You know, if you're not into the first one, you're not going to get anything new from this. But I think it's worth a look. I think it's really nicely put together. It's a nice looking book. The only criticism really is that there's quite a lot where you need to use other props for this. There's quite a lot where you have to bring in something sometimes quite expensive into it. But again, I was thinking, well, there's alternative ways of doing this, and you know, you might get there's quite a lot with kind of impression devices and things like that, which great for stage routines. Which again add a whole different thing. So you've got this thing with the side being solved, but then you've got a thing with two people involved, and that one of them solves the side. There's a great thing where he kind of takes a Michael Murray idea, and you've got this thing where somebody in the audience can do one side of the cube, and you say, can everybody do one side of the cube? And somebody goes, I'll leave that with you, and then they get on with the show, and then you come back to it and go, have you done it right? We'll do something with that. And then someone else matches that person's side, so that behind their back. So you've got all, so that's what I mean by being expanding on an idea and creating, you know, routines you could do on stage. So anyway, there it is. I like it. It's not like going to be for everybody, but I enjoyed it. Whether I'll take the routine and do it is another thing when we come out there. But if you're not into your sort of cube apps and your electronics and you want to do something with a normal cube, I'd recommend having a look at it. It's a nice read. Dark Side of the Cube, Diego Voltini. Have a look at all the links below. Thanks to him for sending it to me. And any questions about this, remember, comments on comment section on the show on Thursday at 5 UK. I will talk about these. That's get your chance to ask any questions on these books live. So come and check it out. Take care. Check out cardmagiccourse.com. Like and subscribe. Have a great one. See you soon.